On the surface, a multi-column lookup table will look like any other table of data, including having a unique column header for each column of the table. Ideally, those column headers will not include any spaces or special characters. One of your columns will serve as the column of values to match against the value that you're looking up. Values in this column should be unique. You'll also need a second column of data that serves as the value you want returned by your lookup function if a match is found. It's okay to have duplicate values here. Depending on your scenario, you may have other columns in the lookup table. That's fine. Regardless, your value to match and the value to be returned must be on the same row of the lookup table. Now, if you're going to use VLOOKUP as your lookup function, you have some additional restrictions on this lookup table. It's imperative that the column of values to match are on the left of the column of the values you want returned from the lookup table. Usually this means that your values to match are on the leftmost column of the lookup table. And if you're using a range lookup, like you need for a gradebook's match of numbered scores to letter grades, make sure your values to match are sorted in ascending order, that is, smallest to largest. If you want the freedom to have the lookup columns be anywhere in your lookup table, and you want to be able to sort range lookups in ascending or descending order, you might want to use index and match on this table instead of VLOOKUP. On this worksheet, I've already typed in one lookup table for grades and one for products. So it should be obvious that you can put your lookup tables anywhere in the worksheet, and provided it makes sense to your application, that you can also centralize all of your lookup tables to the same location in your workbook. So you could leave it here and just start using this lookup table. But you can also take one more step to make this lookup information even easier to manage, and that's turning your lookup tables into Excel tables. To do this, simply select the entire lookup table, including headers. Then, with the table selected, from the Insert tab of the ribbon, select Table. In the pop-up window for Create Table, double-check that Excel is listing the range of cells you wanted to select, and then make sure that the option for My Table Has Headers is checked. Then select OK. A few things have happened here, like formatting the table so that alternating rows are colored for easier readability. Excel has also put a small visual indicator in the bottom right corner of the bottom row of the table. This lets you know where Excel thinks the table ends. To make this table easy to reference in your lookup functions, give this table a descriptive name. With any cell of the table selected, you should see a new menu on the ribbon called Table or Table Design. And then all the way to the left side of the ribbon, you should see a text box labeled Table Name. One has been automatically assigned by Excel, but you can create your own by typing a replacement name into that box. Keep this name as short as possible while still being descriptive. No spaces and no special characters. I'll call this one Grades. Compared to just using worksheet names and cell references, there will be some changes to how to reference it in your lookup functions. If you have questions, or this video helped you with your own project, tell me about it in the comments.